I'm going to demonstrate how to do this cool effect where when you shoot an enemy with an arrow, instead of the arrow disappearing, it sticks into the enemy. Normally I build things from scratch in tutorials, but today it's quite a lot of code and I'll just go through it line by line instead of trying to remember how to build it. So we have, this is an archer's bow straight out of the gallery. This is just a prop that I've got here for practicing. This is a logic cube that has no brain in it. And this is just a standard goblin that I've resized. The only difference here is I've changed his brain properties. I've turned template to true, so he's a template. And then under his combat, health and defenses, I turned off destroy after death. That's just because he was disappearing before we could see him. And then in the character, I've set up that when left bumper is pressed, a goblin is created at that logic cube facing toward me. And then if I hit right bumper, it removes the goblin, just for testing. And then I have right trigger to trigger whether the goblin is visible or not. And I'll show that in a minute. One more thing in the player's brain. I have, when the bow is equipped, it checks to see if you can shoot. When the archer's bow is not equipped, the Y button is not being checked anymore because it's an indented line here. That turns off the magic fireball shot that we have by default on a default character. After the shoot tile, if you place an object, it uses that as a projectile. So I've chosen this archer's arrow. That's this yellow arrow that I have on the ground here. This arrow is a template, and so what will happen is it will fire a copy of this arrow whenever I use the shoot button. I also have this other arrow. It's also a template. And it has no brain. I'll show why I have that in a minute. So, most of the code is in this. These first two lines are default code. That's what you normally would see on an arrow. Starting with line 3, we have ray cast hit, direction forward, looking for objects at a length of 1. So what this does is every brains run at 30 frames per second, so 30 times per second. It looks 1 meter ahead of wherever this object is. A raycast hit, what it does is it shoots out an invisible beam in whatever direction you specify, looking for whatever you tell it to look for. So I'm looking for objects. So if it sees an object 1 meter away, it will create, this is an object variable called arrow, equals to create archer's arrow. This is pointed to that second arrow that I showed you on the ground there. At the position of hit position, hit position is when you use raycast hit, you get this folder of outputs. Hit position is wherever on the object that it's hitting. So we're doing at position hit position minus hit surface normal multiplied by 0.85. What this does is hit surface normal, when you use a raycast, wherever that beam hits, the hit surface normal shows you the direction that the texture that you're hitting is facing. So we just use this to, this is sort of an offset of where the arrow is being created, and it just makes it a little closer to the character, because at first, without this line here, the arrows were sort of hovering right outside of the characters. So, and then arrow backward equals hit surface normal. This orients the arrow so that the point of the arrow is always facing toward the wherever you hit on the character, so that just makes the arrow point the right way. So I say it refers to whatever this raycast hit, which will be in our case a goblin. So the goblin attaches the arrow to its center socket. What that does is this arrow is, whenever the goblin walks around, the arrow will go with it. It becomes an attachment for the goblin. So this yellow arrow is the one that's actually being fired, and when it hits anything, it's going to disappear. That's the normal behavior for an arrow in Project Spark. This other arrow is the one that's being created and will be attached to the target, in this case a goblin. So I'll show that in action. So pick up my bow. I'm going to spawn a goblin. And as you can see, These hit pretty deep into the goblin, but you can see the butts of the arrows sticking out there. Let's do another goblin. Maybe we'll see a little better. Okay, so he flipped over. We need one that's not flipped over. Goblins get nervous during testing. They never do what you want them to do. There we go. So you can see these arrows are all sticking out. So it's easier to see when he's dead. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit that right trigger that I have to toggle visibility. And you can see that all the arrows are pointing toward the center at the angle which they hit the goblin. So I think that's a pretty cool effect. This is a little bit complex code. So instead of just giving you only the video, I'm going to share this level. I'm going to call it... I think I already have it shared. Stuck Arrows. I'm going to take away the 2 HP. So it's going to be called Stuck Arrows, and this is my username. So you can look for that in the community stream. I'm going to leave it up at least for a couple weeks because I know not everyone's watching this at the same time. So that's a pretty cool effect that I thought I would show to you.